Let's take a look or continue our discussion of measurements of location and position, and let's talk about the median. Now that we've looked at the mean, let's look at the other of the two most favorite or most popular measurements of the center, that being the median. Now, in English, let's take a look at this parameter and statistic thing again. In English, we talk about the median. The parameter is a Greek letter theta. It's a circle with a dash through it. That's theta. Like T-H-E-T-A, theta. The statistic is a letter, capital letter, M. And it measures the center of data, and specifically, it's the physical center. So, let's consider our data values 1, 2, and 3 again. The mean was 2. Here's x bar. But who's physically in the middle? Oh, it's 2 again. So in this case, 2 is a physical value in the center, and it's the average. So it's both the mean and the median. It's the same value for both. The reason for that is because the data is symmetric. 1, 2, and 3, it's uniform. The distance, every data value is equally distance apart. As soon as I change one of these values, just pick one of them and change it, the mean is going to change. Let's take a look at another example. We looked earlier at the values 1, 30, and 32, and we said the mean, x bar, was 21. Again, I'm using x bar because I'm assuming this is sample data. But what value is physically in the middle? That's 30. So right there is the median. The median is a guy physically in the center. There's three data values, 1, 30, and 32. 30 is physically the guy in the center of the data. The average is 21. So in this case, the mean and the median don't agree with each other. Okay, how do we calculate the median? First of all, you have to sort your data. If you're going to calculate the median by hand, and later I'll show you how to do it in the calculator, but if you're going to do it by hand, the data must be sorted. If you're calculating the mean, who cares if it's sorted or not? It's irrelevant. First, we want to identify the location of the median within your data set. The formula for the location, L, is N, the sample size, plus 1 divided by 2. Well, in the example with 1, 2, and 3, N is 3, 3 plus 1 is 4 divided by 2 is 2 is the second value. 1, 2. There it was. If n is odd, the median will be a data value from your data set. If n is even, the median may or may not be a value from your data set. It depends on the actual values. There's no requirement, absolutely no requirement whatsoever, that the mean or the median actually be values in your data set. There's no requirement at all. Matter of fact, look back here. This one. We said the mean was 21. Was 21 a data value? No. Our data values are 1, 30, and 32. 21 is not a data value at all. In this case, the number of data values is odd. There's three of them, and sure enough, the median was 30. Okay, let's take a look at another example. Suppose we have the values 23, 19, and 21. First thing I want to do is sort them. Okay, so now it's sorted, smallest to largest. And it equals 3, which is odd. So location is going to be, now let me change ink. I want to go back to black. The location is going to be 3 plus 1 divided by 2, which is 4 divided by 2, which is 2. The second value is 21. So in this case, the median here would be 21. Now I'll consider the values 23, 19, 21, and 27. Now I have 4. Well, again, I want to sort the data. Sorted, I'll have, 19, 21, 23, and 27. Notice N is even here. Okay, the location is still going to be N equals 4 plus 1 divided by 2. That's 5 divided by 2, which is 2.5. This 0.5 is telling you it's in between the second and third value. It's going to be here, in between 21 and 23. Well, what's between 21 and 23? There's an infinite number of possibilities. But by convention, what we do is we say, all right, I'm going to take the second value and the third value and take the average. 21 plus 23 divided by 2 gives me 22. So I would report the median M as being 22, which is, in fact, a value between 21 and 23, and not a part of our data set. Now, let's just suppose, just for sake of conversation, let's just pretend like the data happened to be 19, 21, 21, 27. Okay? Well, this time I'd be averaging 21 and 21. And the average of 21 is, or average of 21 and 21 is 21, so the median would be 21. In that instance, the median would actually be a value from your data set. In this instance, with 19, 21, 23, and 27, it is not a value. Again, there's absolutely no requirement whatsoever that the median or the mean actually be a data value that's in your data set. The mean is typically thought of as being the single best measurement of the center of a distribution if the distribution is symmetric. If the data is not symmetric, if you look at the histogram and the thing is not symmetric, then the median is typically thought of as being the single best measurement. The reason for that is the mean is extremely sensitive to extreme values. The median is invariant. Invariant means take a value on either end, change it, make it huge or make it really small. The median doesn't change, but the mean will. All right, let's take a look at an example. Let's suppose we have data that consists of 1, 2, and 9. Well, the average is going to be 4, but the median is 2. See, if I were to draw this on the number line, I have 1, 2, out here someplace is 9. The mean, x bar, is up here at 4. So what's been happening is where the median is at 2, the mean is being pulled toward that extreme value. This data would be thought of as probably being skewed right, although with three data values, I mean, it's kind of hard to say what shape is. It's, yeah, skewed. But if you had a bunch of data in a skewed right, the mean would be pulled toward the extreme values, be pulled toward the right. If it was skewed left, then the median would be set there physically in the middle, and the mean would get pulled in the direction of the tail if it's skewed left. Take a look at another example. Suppose I had data values 1, 2, and 21. X bar is 8. The median is 2. Suppose I had values 1, 2, and 30. X bar is 11. The median is 2. Well, how about if I had data values 1, 2, and 60? X bar is 21. The median is 2. See, the median is invariant. I took that last value and I kept making it bigger, bigger, and bigger, and left the other values alone. The mean kept getting pulled out farther and farther and farther. The median, being invariant, it doesn't move, it just sits right there. Said, okay, I don't care, and sits right there. Boom, there it is. That's what we mean when we say, or that's the meaning of, the idea of the mean being sensitive to extreme values. It gets pulled in the direction of those extreme values. Whereas the median is invariant, it just simply sits there. Okay, in the next section, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a really brief video and show you how to find the mean and the median on your calculators.